So Arnie Johnson was a 19-year-old kid who ultimately was convicted of manslaughter for the death of his girlfriend's boss. What's interesting about the case is it was the first time that a lawyer had actually used the idea of demonic possession as an exculpatory device to get him off of the murder charge. So in court, not guilty by reason of possession. Ed and Lorraine were involved in this case. They were investigators in it. And we thought it was a really interesting story to tell as the next Conjuring. What we wanted to make sure we were doing was not repeating what we had done in the past with the first two Conjuring movies. We wanted to keep our new story grounded in the lore and in the feel of Conjuring movies, but we wanted to make sure we were telling a brand new story. And we think the Arnie Johnson story was something that really deserved a much closer look. Patrick and Vera are such extraordinary actors, and we knew this from the moment we started working with them on the first Conjuring movie. They have given Ed and Lorraine such personality, such love, such depth. And the opportunity to work with them again on Conjuring 3 was something that we simply could not pass up. We're really exploring the idea of a curse rather than a pure demonic possession. They love the idea of doing something new. What's great at this point is we don't need to introduce Ed and Lorraine to the audience. People already know who they are. They already love them. So we can spend a lot more time just on the story of Conjuring 3 rather than spending time introducing the characters. It was a big deal for James to give up the keys to the Conjuring car. You know, he has really put so much blood, sweat, tears, creativity, ingenuity into crafting the entire Conjuring universe, and specifically as the filmmaker of Conjuring 1 and Conjuring 2. So it was a big deal for him to, you know, pass his child, if you will, to another parent. But I think working with Michael Shavs on The Curse of La Llorona gave him tremendous confidence in doing so. And I think the team that we have put around Michael Shavs, with myself, David Leslie Johnson, our cinematographer, our production design, all the other people that have moved through the Conjuring universe with us, I think gave James tremendous confidence that Shavs would be able to deliver a film that not only lives up to the first two Conjurings, but maybe even surpasses it.